you. Today we did a lot of Colgada, and we started off with a lot of walking and figuring out how to stand and posture and whatnot, and you can see that in our other videos. Some of the important things that we talked about today was for follows to not take any steps without them being explicitly led. Often follows will see a pattern and start to complete that pattern, or leads will assume, because they've danced with follows who do this, that a pattern will always be finished. And so we focused a lot today on making sure that didn't happen. Now we got straight into the move. The moves that we did today were all about Colgada. And the first one that we did was a nice side step into Colgada. And we had a little bit of exercise in this. We did step out. The exercise we did, holding your hands like this, leaning inwards, leaning outwards, trying to keep a nice planked body. If you stick all your arms out or you like bend outwards, it makes things very unstable. So we spent a lot of time working on that. Then we got to the actual move. The actual move was a side step with a sandwich. And broken down, this is a lot harder because of momentum issues. But basically the idea is that the leg will come forward, take that axis, ask for weight, and go into the Colgada. And then to return, join at the same axis, and step out. So we practiced that for a little while, and then we got to do it smoothly. And asking for that weight without fully separating out these parts. And we did side to side, a little bit of side Colgada, and then finally the step over, which required the follow to be fully on the side of the lead, and they step out to stabilize themselves. So we did that, we had that. the second Colgada we did was a promenade Colgada, which was from four Oshos, step, and weight. And this, once again, we have a straight line in the body for the lead, straight line in the body for the follow. We talked about being able to come